Bless you.
Yeah.
What's your name?
Fred.
Fred. Amen. You got something?
Yeah.
All right.
I got my haircut.
You got your haircut? Wow, wow. So what, you got clothes too? You got clothes? That's good. So so did you receive Christ? Are you a Christian?
Yeah.
Or you receive Christ?
I got a temple praise.
Temple praise. Oh, okay.
Bishop State and Lord State.
Okay, how you like it?
I already got baptized.
Yeah. So that means if the world was to end now,
yeah.
You make it to heaven, right?
Yeah.
You believe there's heaven?
Yeah.
Wow.
Didn't have to change it back in the day. I like your phone, man.
Thank you so
much.
This is Galaxy S8 Plus. That's good, man. What's your name?
Fred.
Oh yeah, that's a Fred. Where you live?
I live in Philadelphia.
Okay.
801.
So you
can have
So you come here often, right?
Yeah.
Okay. That's good. I want you to be encouraged, man. Jesus loves you.
I know
you know. I'm glad you know, man. So when you come out to fellowship like this, man, just encourage one another.
I go to a church around the corner.
Okay.
They do repetition.
Every Sunday? Where is the church?
I go down here on 12th Street.
On 12th Street? Okay.
It's not far from the world, man.
Huh?
No.
Okay. All right. Awesome, man. It is such a beautiful day. Such a beautiful day. You got a lot of people out here. How you doing? How you doing? Oh, really?
That's Patrick.
Patrick, oh my goodness. Yeah. So you got your Bible?
No.
You don't have no Bible? Why?
I like reading the Bible sometimes. You know.
That's good. You got to grow in the Lord. Yeah. God bless you, my brother. Be safe. You got enough food, right?
Thank you.
here to minister to the homeless, to the poor, and the needy. You know, Christianity is showing the glory of God to the needy. It's showcasing love, because the love of God has been shed abroad our hearts. And where do you show that love? You show that love to the less privileged. You know, as advanced as this nation is, you'll be surprised to see that a lot of people, they are homeless. A lot of people, they go hungry. Some have been pulled out of their houses. Some don't have any income. They don't even know where the next meal is going to come. So what we do is to go out and encourage people, encourage them with the word of God, and share in what God has blessed us with. One of the greatest things that you can do on this earth is to put a smile on somebody who is in need. Put a smile in their face. You know what Jesus said? He says, the poor you will always have. You will always have the poor. And God's heart after the poor is so, you know, he has so much heart towards the poor. And that's what Christianity is all about. Christianity is showing the love of God, you know, to the poor. Not taking advantage of the innocent, the poor, and the needy, but showing love to them. You know, if you really want to see God, God is not in a building. God is in people. And a Christian who doesn't have love for people, it's not a Christian. You don't have the love of God. It's so amazing where I see so many people trying to take advantage of, you know, the poor in spirit. But God really wants us to show love to the poor, and, you know, build them up, encourage them. I met some of the guys here that I've ministered to before, and just share the word of God to them, because they don't have anyone that will comfort them. Some of these people, they got in trouble, they lost their houses, they lost their job, they even lost their mind. And some of them sleep on the streets. You know, as advanced as the United States of America is, when you tell people that there are homeless people here, they don't believe. It's not only in Africa that you have poor people. You know, whenever you see the poor, minister to them with the word of God. Let your life be an encouragement to them. Take time to encourage them. Take time to minister yourself to them. Even your presence alone, when you allow the anointing of God to flow from you to them, it's a great asset. You know, what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 25 is very important. So many people will find out on the last day that they cannot enter heaven. And not because of sin, but because of who they are and what they did on earth. You have one life to live. You have one opportunity. How you doing, brother? What's going on? You cool? So, you only have one opportunity to let God know why came to this earth. You know, when you read, Matthew, let me open to you. Glory to God. Yeah, anytime you want to see God, when you want to visit God, when you want to give to God, the best place is to go to the needy and you see God. Don't take my word for it. You know, we just had a good fellowship today, talking about kingdom prosperity. God will ask you, what did you do with the talents that he gave to you? What did you do with the money he gave to you? What did you do with the skills that he gave to you last day? Some of us have been so programmed to look for God in the wrong place. Yeah, how you doing? What's going on?
I guess they got something left to eat. I'm late.
You late? Oh, I'm sure they still have some stuff there.
Yeah, I'm going to go get some. Yeah, I usually like hitting the service, but...
So why come you late today?
Well, I know. I live all the way in the cars, and I've been sick, and my mom been sick, my sister missing. So I've been going through that, but God is good, though.
You've been sick? What's been going on? Why are you sick?
I have osteoarthritis in my knees.
Oh.
I got a fluid bill in my heart, so I couldn't be out
Can
here.
Can I pray with you?
Oh, sure.
Thank you, Father. Precious Lord. You know, I just want to encourage you to let you know that no matter the pain that you are going through, sickness or whatever it is, Jesus is still healing.
Yeah.
He's still healing today.
I know that. Yeah.
You know, the Bible tells us that He took all our sins, all our sickness, all our disease.
Oh, yeah, I know. I'm a Christian. I know.
Glory to God. Wow. So I'm just
You're the second
gonna...
person to pray for me before I came, because I had to walk halfway, because I walked because I can't get the exercise.
Okay.
And then I got off the X2 bus, so.
Just be encouraged, okay?
Yeah, I am. Thank
You're
you,
encouraged.
Jesus.
I see
Thank
you have faith already.
Yeah, my name
right.
is
Sister, Brenda.
Sister Scott, they call
Sister Scott. Wow, yeah. Glory to God. So your knees are hurting you, or what?
Well, they're just a little pain. I take medicine for them. Meloxicam, I take that, so.
All right.
It's helping me lose some weight. That's a good thing.
You know, I love
I
what you
lot
say.
Of medications. You say you
lay hands on the sick and the sick will recover.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And that's
why
I'm saying, joining my hand with you.
Yeah.
Because as I'm laying this hand upon you, the anointing of God is flowing into your body.
Are you a pastor?
Am I a pastor?
Yeah,
I'm a believer. Man. You know, Jesus is
so
pastor. But I pray in the name of Jesus that you receive your healing now. Be healing your body.
I'm going to come back.
Jesus. You will come back. Okay,
yeah,
I will be here.
All right,
go get something. Glory to God. Bless you. You know, I was just about to share with you. What the Lord said. By the way, that's a lady that we have ministered to in the past, and she came for food. And you know, when I see people like this, I kind of feel God. Hey, how you doing? You got enough to eat, brother? You got enough to eat, right? All right. Be good, all right? Take care. You know what Jesus said in Matthew 25. Every day I ruminate over this verse, over this scripture, and I see how a lot of people in the Christian world has really missed it. Even me, when I was still pastoring churches, I used to do things based on what I was told, based on the doctrine. But I found out the best thing to do is to do what God says, take chance with God. And this is what Jesus said in verse 31 of Matthew 25. Glory to God. He said, when the Son... Holy Spirit, I feel your presence here already. Thank you, Lord. When the Son of Man comes in His glory, and all the holy angels with Him, then He will sit on the throne of His glory. I've preached this over and over. And every time I read this verse, I have to come back again. You know, I read it over and over. It's unfortunate that so many so-called Christians, they will die and sleep and find themselves in the wrong place. But as long as you have the word of God, you can correct yourself, you can make amends, you can repent. I believe it's better to do what the Master says than to do what you want to, you know, what you feel. Jesus here said, when the Son of Man comes in His glory and all His holy angels with Him, then He will sit on the throne of His glory. All the nations will be gathered before Him, and He will separate them one from another as a shepherd divides his sheep from the goats. And He will set the sheep on His right hand, but the goats on the left. Now, this is something that will happen. It has not happened. It will happen. Whether you like it or not, Jesus is coming back. And He has already put this as a law. It's a principle. You know, in verse 33 of Matthew 25, and He will set the sheep on the right hand, but the goats on the left. Then the king will say to those on His right hand, come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. That means the kingdom of God was prepared for us. The kingdom of God was prepared even before we were born. We are here on this earth, not as an accident, but to showcase the love of Christ, to showcase God. Wow. So the kingdom of God was prepared. So Jesus is now telling us the requirements of making this beautiful kingdom. I trust that you want to enter the kingdom of God. You know, some places they talked about sin, everything is sin. But the fact is that Jesus took all the sins. He dealt with sin on the cross. And now Jesus is telling us how to enter the kingdom. in verse 35. Well, let me go back to verse 33, Matthew 25. Then the king will say to those on his right hand, come, you blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. God wants us to inherit the kingdom. It was prepared for us. Wow. And now tells us, for I was hungry and you gave me food. I was thirsty and you gave me drink. I was a stranger and you took me in. This is Jesus talking. He said in verse 36, he was naked and you clothed him. Sick, you visited him. He was in prison, you came to him. Verse 37, then the righteous will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and gave you drink? Verse 38, when did we see you a stranger and take you in, or naked and clothe you? Verse 39, or when did we see you sick or in prison and come to you? And verse 40, this is the master talking. And the king will answer and say to them, as surely I say to you, inasmuch as you did it to one of the least of these, my brethren, you did it to me. Jesus is calling this decentralized, poor people, hopeless people, his brethren. And he said, as long as you did it to them, you do it to him. Wow, isn't that wonderful? As much as you did to them. So when you neglect the poor, when you neglect the disenfranchised, when you neglect the needy and build your own empire, you are setting up yourself for destruction, eternal destruction. And I pray that will not be a portion in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Wow. Look at verse 41. Those who refuse to recognize God in the poor, those who refuse to recognize God in the needy, this is what happened to them. I pray that this short video will be a blessing to you. Then he was also said to those on the left hand, depart from me, you cursed, into the everlasting fire. Prepare for the devil and the agent. See,
are you doing it? You
want to sit
here?
Okay, you can sit with me. I'm just doing Bible study. Okay, alright. Did you get something?
I'm trying to get you something cold.
What do you want to eat?
Popsicle.
Oh, popsicle. Okay. We'll see if we can get you some. Now, it says, verse 41, then he will also say to those on the left, depart from me, you cursed, into the everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angel. The everlasting fire was prepared for the devil and his angel, not for human beings. Verse 42, now Jesus now starts talking. He said, for I was hungry, you gave me no food. I was thirsty, you gave me no drink. I was a stranger, you did not take me in. He said he was naked, you didn't clothe him. He was sick in prison, you did not visit him. Oh dear. Verse 44, then they also will answer him, saying, Lord, when did we see you hungry, or thirsty, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not minister to you? Verse 45, then he will answer them, saying, surely I say to you, inasmuch as you did not do it to one of these least of these, you did not do it to me. And this will go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. This is the master speaking. And that's why we reach out to the needy. That's why we reach out to the poor. Because you can only give to God when you give to the poor. You give to God when you visit hospital, when you visit the sick, pray for the sick. When you are not ashamed to show God's love to the poor. That is how you give to God. And if you are a Christian and you don't have anything to do with the poor, the homeless, the sick, or the disenfranchised, then you are missing out. I just trust that this short video will be a blessing to you. And I came here and announced every Sunday. I come here to fellowship outside. This is church in the park. It has become a part of us. So as you can see, they are enjoying themselves, having a good time. And of course, I'm here having a good time. There's a lady that just came over here, sick in her body, so I'm going to go over to share the word of God and pray with her. And this is how you do church, because God is in the people. and I pray that this verse will be a blessing to you, that you will take the word of God seriously. We are not going to miss heaven, but as long as you have breath, as long as you can watch this video today, there is hope for you. There is hope for you. And when you attend to the needy, when you attend to the poor, God will come to your aid. God will rescue you. We are not doing this to show up, but we are doing it because it's what the Master says. So I'm here at the park, just having a fellowship. I'm just going to go and okay, I'm coming. Yes, I'm coming. I'm done. All right. All right. Until next time, this has been your lovely brother, Brother Ambrose. And spread the word. Jesus love you. I love you. See you in my next. God bless you. Bye-bye.